Hi guys, what's up? This is Zen and you're watching Zen Tech and Learning. And today I'm back with another video where we are going to discuss about Windows 11, how we can update the Windows 11 on Windows 10 machine. So today in this video, it is going to be a very important because I'm going to talk about because my machine is not meeting the Windows 11 requirements, but still I successfully updated the Windows 11 on my machine. So how that could be possible? All right. So please watch this video from starting to end and you are going to understand each and every bit of it. All right. So without wasting any time, so let's start the video. So I'm going to show you up something, guys. So right now I have a Windows 11 running on my machine, which is basically not meeting the Windows 11 requirements. All right, so let me just give you an overview how it is working, and let me show you up the proof because my machine is not compatible, even though I updated the Windows 11 on my machine successfully. All right, so let me take you through it. I'm going to open the PC Health Check application, and I'm going to show you up the proof. So this is the PC Health Check application, and which will let you know because of Microsoft, they designed this application for checking the compatibility of your machine with Windows 11, whether your machine is meeting the requirements of Windows 11 or it is not meeting the requirement. If your PC is not meeting the Windows 11 requirements, then you will not be able to update the Windows 11 on your machine. But still, there's a way. I will let you know in this video. You can update the machine with the Windows 11. So let me just show you up my machine. About my machine, when I click on check now, it is saying that, clearly saying that this PC does not currently meet the Windows 11 requirements. So that shows I cannot update the Windows 11 on my machine. So I got very disappointed. I thought, one of my machine is working fine with the Windows 11. I got the Windows 11 update on 5th October, and since then I'm using it. It's working smoothly fine. But this particular machine is not meeting the requirement. This is saying that this processor currently not supporting the Windows 11. So I got disappointed, but I got one trick and which I'm going to reveal here, and I will let you know how you guys can update your machine with the Windows 11 without any issue, even if your machine is not meeting the requirements. So about this application, I created another video. I will put the link in the description. You can go through it, how you can download this application to check the Windows 11 requirements. All right, and if I go to File Manager, and let me show you up something under the File Manager. So under the File Manager, I open twice. Okay, so under the File Manager, I go to this PC, and so when I right click here and I click on the properties, it will take you on the page where it will let you know your machine is running on Windows 10 or Windows 11. So my machine is running with the Windows 11 Pro because the previous version was Windows 10 Pro, so I got the Windows 11 Pro on my machine. All right, so and I'm using it since last couple of days and it's working smoothly fine. So I thought I should be sharing this trick with you guys so that you can also update your machine to Windows 11. All right, so before going further, I want you to take a backup of your data. Although it is a tested method, I'm using it on my machine, on my colleague or friend's machine also. It's running absolutely fine without any issue. I have been using it since last 15 or 20 days. It's running smoothly fine. But Microsoft also recommend if you are going to update your machine with the Windows 10 to Windows 11, they recommend to take a backup of your data because Windows basically is a versatile operating system, but there are possibilities it might crash or something might happen wrong. So would request you please take a backup of your data, and so that you will be you will be sure like you have the backup anywhere, and if anything goes wrong, then you can keep your file back from the backup. All right, so let me tell you how we can update the machine which is not compatible which is not meeting the requirement of Windows 11. So alright, so guys, let me take you through the process. And so first of all, ensure that you are connected with a good Wi-Fi connection. And after that, you have to open the Google Chrome and you have to type here Windows 11 Update Assistant. I will put the link in the description so that you can easily download it that. And so we have to click on this download Windows 11 Microsoft. And so we will get this particular page. And now Windows 11 Assistant is for if your PC is meeting the Windows 11 requirements, but mine is not. I will not go with this option. And even the second option is not gonna work for me, because this is again for you know, the machine which is meeting the Windows 11 requirement. I will go with the third option. I will directly download the Windows 11 ISO image. Alright, how we are gonna download that? I have already done that because I updated my machine, and I thought I should be sharing this experience after doing that. So we have to follow this particular options, and we have to select as English International, and then we have to click on 64-bit download. So if your machine is a 32-bit, it will automatically detect that. So mine is a 64-bit. The moment we click on 64-bit download, the file will be started downloading in your machine. Do you see that? So let me show you up here in download section. So mine speed is a little bit good, so it is coming like 5.1 gig total sizes, and that is going to take at least 1 hour of time. Because I have already done that. At the bottom, you can already see that Windows 11 installation.exe, and there is a MSI file image I have already downloaded. So I have already followed that. I'm going to close it, and I'm going to come back to the home screen. Now let me show you up. I have downloaded and put it there in the directory E drive. Yep, so in the E drive, so I have basically downloaded here. Let me show you up. Your download may be going to the download section. So I have downloaded and put it here. Again, my machine is not meeting the requirement. So yeah, this is the image which I have downloaded from the Microsoft. I have to right click on it. When we right click, we will get the option. Let me show you up how you can get the option, because right now I extracted to the Windows folder. You can also create your own folder where you want. So I created this Windows folder, and I right click on this image file, and when you right click, you will see some, you have to go to the more options, and you have to click on extract files. I have to click on extract files. It is going to ask me where I want to extract. I want to select as a E drive and Windows 11. All right, and I will click on OK. So do you see that it has been started? So it is extracting all the files from this image to the Windows 11 folder. So I'm not gonna go with that. I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna leave it as it is. Let me show you up. So Windows in this particular folder, I have already extracted. So let me take you inside this. You will see these all the folders inside the extracted file. So you have to go to the source. There's a trick. Now let me tell you, when you come to the extract file, wherever you have extracted, I extract the file into the Windows folder. So you have to go to that folder. Then you have to go to the source folder, and in the sources folder, you have to basically bypass the requirement thing when your Windows is checking the requirement. So you have to bypass that. First of all, make sure you have disconnected the Wi-Fi of your machine. All right, you can simply disconnect the Wi-Fi. Or if you leave it as it is, there's no problem. But I would recommend you disconnect the Wi-Fi. And then one file you have to delete it. And let me tell you, this file is basically checking the requirement first, and then it will deploy the Windows 11 on your machine. So we just want to wipe out that particular step. It should not be checking the requirement. It will directly start the installation on your machine. So this is the file. Do you see that? This is the appraiser rres.dll. So this is the file you have to look. Make sure, guys, you are deleting this particular file. You can have a look again. This is the appraiser RRES dot E dot DLL. Alright, so you have to right click on it and you have to simply delete that particular file. Alright, when we delete that, alright, so we have to go back to the Windows folder and we have to click on right click on the setup file and we have to run as an administrator and we will get the pop-up yes or no. We have to click on yes and then after the installation will be started like this. And do you see how much faster it is going? And after that you will directly get the installation Windows 11 installation page. And so we have to click on this particular option and we have to click on not at the moment and check the box. And when we check the box and then we have to click on next. All right, now checking your PC, it is not asking you your PC is not compatible, directly giving you the license accept. You have to accept that and making sure you are ready to install. So I'm not gonna do it again, the Windows 11 update, but I am just giving you a few steps so that you understand that how I updated my machine even my machine is not compatible. So it is right now checking your PC has enough space. So make sure guys you have at least more than 20 gig space in your C drive. If you don't have a space, then make sure you are creating a space by taking the backup or whatever you are doing. So make sure you have a more than 20 gig space. So now it will ask you certain options. So we have to click on next. Okay, and ready to install. It's really great. I mean, my PC is going to install with the Windows 11 Pro. Now change what to keep. Yeah, so we have to click on that. This is a very important. Keep personal files and applications. We have to check this box. So make sure you are also checking the first box, keep personal files and the application. We have to click on next. Now making sure you are ready to install. So I don't want to do that again because I already done that Windows 11 on my machine. But again, if you want to do that, then definitely it's a very good method. Basically I updated my machine from Windows 10 to Windows 11. Even that was not compatible, but I did not lose any data or anything on my machine. So guys, when I was updating my machine from Windows 10 to 11, I captured this particular screen. I thought I should be sharing the experience with you guys. So yep, so in this particular process I followed next, and after that I got this installation Windows 11 page, and it was going from 1% to 100%, and when it went to the 100%, it basically it moved to the next screen. And where it also went to the 100%, and I had to wait a lot because I had to wait like approximate 1 hour 30 minutes, and after that finally I got the message Zentech and Learning welcome, circling dots, hi, everything is getting ready for you. And so I basically make the video fast forward it. So it was talking about like couple of things. Do not unplug the charger, keep your PC on, and everything is ready to go almost. When I got the Windows 11, so I thought I should be checking that whether it is a Windows 11 Pro, because my machine was Windows 10 Pro. So I should be getting Windows 11. Yes, I should be getting Windows 11 Pro. So yes, I got the Windows 11 Pro on my machine. But in your case, if your PC is running on the Windows 10 Home, then you will get the Windows 10 Windows 11 Home version. All right, so thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you have any concern or any issues, please mention in a comment section, and please do like, subscribe my channel so that you will get each and every update. And if you want me to create any other video, you can mention in a comment section. All right, thank you so much guys for watching this video. Bye now.